Hello, welcome again. We are solving some questions of machine design. The topic is riveted joint. Question number 20 is a bracket is supported by means of 4 rivets of same size as shown in figure. So this is 30, this is 30, this is 30, and eccentric load is acting at a eccentricity of 80 and its value is 20 kN. Question number the question is the size of rivet if the maximum shear stress is 140 MPa. Option A 20 mm, option B 13 mm, option C 14 mm and option D 18 mm. So this is your schematic arrangement. This is rivet 1, this is rivet 2, this is rivet 3, this is 4, and eccentric load of 20 kN is acting at a distance 80 from this eccentricity. Okay, so as these are the symmetrical arrangement, this is a symmetrical arrangement and the distance between the rivets is same, so the center of this arrangement will lie at this point, which is at a 30 plus 15 45 mm from 1 or 4 and 15 mm from 3 or 2. Okay, so as this load is your eccentric load and this will cause two types of load on the rivet. One is direct load and another is secondary load. So direct load is equally distributed among these rivets as there are 4 number of rivets. So direct load on each rivet is your 20 by 4, that is 5 kN. So F will be equal to 5 kN and it will act in downward direction because 20 kN is acting in downward direction and this F is due to this load. Okay. Now secondary load is due to movement of this load. Moment of this load is 20 into 1000 into 80. As it is causing clockwise movement, so the load generated by secondary load generated by this 20 kN eccentric load should also generate a clockwise moment. So to generate clockwise moment, F1 will act in this direction and F2 will act in this direction, or we can say the direction of the load F1 will be the line will be perpendicular to the line joining the center of the configuration to the center of the rivet. Okay, so this is the line joining the center of the configuration and center of rivet, and it's perpendicular is this, and it should cause clockwise movement, so that's why it is in this direction. Similarly, F2 is in this direction and F3 is in this direction, line joining the center of the configuration and center of rivet. Okay, and this is your F3. Similarly, F4 will act in this direction. Okay, so now if we take moment about center, then it will be F1 into 45, F2 into 15, F3 into 15 and F4 into 45, as it is causing clockwise movement, and this clockwise movement should be equal to this clockwise movement. So that clockwise movement is 20 into 80 or into 1000. Okay. So this is the equation of moment, F1 into 45 plus F2 into 15 plus F3 into 15 plus F4 into 45 should be equal to 20 into 80 into 1000. Okay. So now as this load is causing torsion in the bracket, okay, and F1 is your secondary shear stress, F2 is your F1, F2, F3, F4 are secondary shear stress, sorry, secondary shear force. If we divide it by area, then it will cause, they will cause secondary shear stress, or we can say it is torsional shear stress, and we know that the torsional shear stress in torsion equation P by J is equal to tau by R. So the shear stress caused by this F1 divided by R1 should be equal to shear stress caused by this F2 divided by R2, should be equal to shear stress caused by this F3 divided by R3, should be equal to shear stress caused by this F4 divided by R4. Okay. Now area of each rivet is same, so we can neglect the area, or we can take direct the forces. So F1 by R1, F1 by R1, F2 by R2, F3 by R3, and F4 by R4 should be equal. So F1, R1 is 45, R2 is 15, R3 is 15, and R4 is and R4 is 45. So now we can take we can use this and take 45 as common. So if we take 45 as common, then here it will be 45 square and here it will be 15 square, and F1 as common will be we have converted, then F2 will be equal to F1 by 45 into 15. So here it will be F1 by 45 into 15 square. So if we take F1 by 45 common, then it will be 15 square. Similarly, it will be 15 square and it will be 45 square. Okay. Now here unknown thing is F1, so we can find out F1. So F1 is just 15 kilo. So F1 is acting in this direction and F3 is acting in this direction. And the value of F4 will also be same because of this equation. F1 by 45 is equal to F4 by 45. So both of these 1 and 4 are critical events because here the resultant load is resultant of F4 and F, and here the resultant load is F1 and F, resultant of F1 and F. So as they are perpendicular, so resultant load on rivet 1 is just 16, F1 is just 16, and for F is just 15, so 16 square plus 5 square, root 281. Or it is equal to 16.76 kN. So resultant load on rivet 1 is 16.76 kN. Okay. And if we multiply it by multiplied by 1000, then it is in Newton. So that is the load and area is pi by 4 d square. So that is 4 divided by pi. And shear strength is 140 and it will be equal to d square. So d is 12.347 mm, or we can say it is 13 mm. So answer is option B.